Today's moms to learn how to tame morning mania. You probably started out the school year with the best of intentions, but still, just getting the kids up and out of the house has become a total nag fest.
That's
I like
right.
that word.
Today's mom contributor, Amy McCready, has some tips to get kids and parents back on the right track. She is the founder of Positive Parenting Solutions.
And she always actually really has them. Have you
I
noticed?
Know. We do
a lot of people
that.
Talk about it, but she shows up and actually gives you great advice.
Thank
good
you.
To see
it's
you.
Good to
now,
see you
a
both.
Lot of parents wind up nagging their
yes.
kids, especially in the morning. They're late. The bus is out there.
They
we
think
get
that's
into
their
that
job,
mode,
right?
Right.
Well, I think most parents wake up intending for it to be a really good day, but then it turns into this big nag fest.
Yeah.
They're nagging and reminding and yelling at their kids to do the things that they already know they're supposed to do.
Sure.
Such
then,
as?
Well, get to rest, you know, get eat breakfast,
your
you have your homework, you have your lunchbox, and then after all this nonsense, they get them out the door, and they have this feeling like, ugh, another day that started off on a bad note for everybody.
What should kids do without being reminded? Like, what are the things they should do for sure?
Well, by the time they're 4 or 5 years old, they should be able to get themselves up on their own, you know, remember all the daily things they need for school and get out the door on time without reminders from mom and dad.
You talk about the fact that we enable our children in some bad behaviors by mm-hmm. if your child is chronically late and you keep making it okay for them, or your child forgets something at the house
yes.
all the time, and we're in the car and
yeah.
we go into, you say, what should we do in cases like that?
Well, there are a couple of strategies that we can use. The first one is implementing what's called a when-then routine.
Yeah.
And when-then routines are great because it requires that all the yucky stuff, the things that you remind them to do every day, that has to happen before the more fun parts of the routine,
okay.
like breakfast or playtime or TV time. So it sounds like when you're dressed, your bed is made, your hair's combed, your backpack and lunchbox are by the door, then
okay.
come and join us for breakfast. So if they dawdle and don't get everything done, well then the consequence is they may miss out on breakfast or their playtime.
Right. You don't want to send your kid off to a school
I
day
know.
Without breakfast, but you have to
tough
be consistent.
Yeah.
That's right. And you know what will happen? They may be a little bit uncomfortable that first day, but they're not going to starve to death.
Right.
And I promise you, the next day, they're going to be getting through the morning routine quickly
sure.
to get it all done.
What about, I know some parents do charts and stuff. They want
yes.
to make sure that their kids follow along. Is that a good idea?
That's a great idea. That's setting them up for success. So if we implement this when-then routine, you know, work with a child to develop the chart, either with pictures or words, so they can see what they have to do and then put that on their, you know, bedroom door or wherever they'll
sure.
see it, so it's a visual reminder.
How do you feel about the whole TV or a computer in the bedroom?
I really don't advise that at
mm-hmm.
all.
Right.
You know, number one, it's a distraction.
That's
and
what makes them late half the time,
right.
is they're on the computer.
Right. And then, you know, and you're also not able to monitor it very easily
sure.
when it's in their room. So that way, if you can kind of have all of that, all of the yucky stuff done, all
mm-hmm.
the things they have to do before you allow them to have any TV time or, you know, computer
and
time.
What about when kids
best?
Get older, too? Because sometimes you wind up nagging your kids long through
yes.
junior high and high school, not for lunchbox things, but for other things.
I
exactly.
text my nags now.
The beauty of technology.
Right? Don't forget church Sunday morning.
But for the school morning, a great way to handle older kids is to implement what we call the no rescue policy. And that's what you were kind of talking about earlier. A no rescue policy puts the child totally in charge of the morning routine.
And their own destiny.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll sit down with them and say, you know what, you're really growing up. And part of growing up is taking responsibility for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And so now you're going to be in charge of the morning routine. So it's your job to set your alarm. And if you don't set it or you sleep through it, I'm not going to wake
bad
you
for
up.
You.
You're
right.
going to have to explain to the principal why you're late.
Yeah.
You know, if you forget your homework or your lunchbox, you know, that's going
to
be your problem.
Yeah.
And that takes courage because
it is. And you also don't want them to think you're a bad mother
yes.
because you're not
yeah.
helping them.
Right.
You know,
that's right.
It is such a.
Well, you know, to that point, you know, we kind of do worry about what teachers think,
yeah.
but you can always bring them into the loop and let them know what you're doing.
Thanks, Amy.
They're
Thanks
on to
so
us
much.
Anyway, right?
Yeah.
Thank you
so much.
Yeah.